Can you tell us maybe a war story of your own on how you have worked with a client to integrate social media into their communication strategy, and either it be a success story, if you'd like to share, you know, some interesting use of technology, or something that really just completely went wrong, and something that we could learn from, changing dates and names and all that, if you'd like to. But any either success story or failure that, well, we won't say failure, or challenge that you might have seen in your own practice in using social media.
I could tell you that a lot of this stuff is really new. So having failures, while there have been a few documented case studies out there, a lot of this is brand new. And I work specifically with a lot of emerging technology companies, so they're a little bit more tapped into the world of social media. You know, for example, they would rather be in some of the top blogs over the Wall Street Journal, for example. So I'm spending most of my time now working in new media. So, for example, one company that we launched, we had a traditional approach, but we also at the same time, you know, set up some video, a screencast, which basically documented, you know, how the program worked with some voice over, but specifically not demonstrating the product, but talking about how if I were a user planning some sort of activity, how it would work, and we made it kind of funny and entertaining, and we threw it up on YouTube with the right tags, pointed people to it through social networks, and I think that little silly video has about 160,000 views in about a month, and that's bigger and trackable than anything you could possibly hope to get in combination of the New York Times, Wall Street Journal, Time, Newsweek. I mean, it really drives traffic, and it's instantly measurable with a lot of, you know, easy tools. Getting words out, for example, I've had greater success spreading news through Twitter with 140 characters, and driving people to write about things more so than putting a press release over the wire. These are, you know, well, they're not specific examples. I mean, this just kind of gives you an idea of how I use a lot of these tools today. But more importantly, I can tell you this. Every single company that I work with now has to have at least a Twitter, a Facebook, a YouTube, and a blog strategy at the same time coming out of the gate. And some of the things that we're experimenting with now are taking the concept of how viral YouTube is and making online series, not just demonstrations, but sort of like a day in the life of. For example, we're launching a company in a couple of weeks called DocStock, and they're sort of like a Flickr for business documents. And we hired a comedian out of LA, and we follow him around with a camera, going into offices and stealing documents and getting chased out. Saying there's got to be a better way to find business documents and sort of reinforcing the message for DocStock. So we're going to make that a weekly series. But, you know, while it's funny and entertaining, it's still going to bring people to the site. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.